We manufacture javelins here. We have manufactured track and field equipment almost 100 years, and that's our specialty. That's what we do. Javelins started being mass produced in the 40s and 50s, and originally then they were wooden, and then they became metal javelins in the late 60s. We start out with a metal tube. Ours is aluminum. We take that and we put it in our machines and we taper them to our specs and what we want for that model. The molecules and the way aluminum works, when you're putting those kind of forces on it and taking a round tube and tapering it down to a smaller point, they have a tendency to want to drift and move around. So you need to fool them a little bit, especially after other processes are done, the molecules align differently, and you have to bring them back into the shape that you want, which for us would be straight. After they're tapered, we do some more processes to them to get them a little stiffer and to flex the way we want them to. The machine can take out the general bends in it, but it can't take out those fine, small bends. It has to be finally inspected by a person and straightened by hand. We take off any other weight and adjust the diameters to where we want them per IAAF and get our balance point where we want it for each model. You can change the balance drastically and get out of rule very quickly by sanding. So we have a way we want that done and we do it. The javelin has to weigh 805 grams to leave the factory, but that's overall weight and balance at a certain spot at that weight. So we adjust that with lead and know what we want. After it's sanded, checked for diameter and weight and gets the balance where we want it, then they get painted. After they're painted, they'll come back to the builder station and they'll check it again to make sure it's where we want it within spec, and then they go to have the grip put on them. We have two different styles. We have a general big, and then we have one that pushes the limits on where we have to be for the rules. Rules say we can be no bigger than 8 millimeters front of the grip. We try to get at that point for the high-end elite throwers. After the grip's put on, it's checked again, and then the javelin's cleaned, decaled, and then straightened again for a final check to make sure everything's right. And then put out for sale.